Yo, that's more than three yo's. Welcome back. I am CPA Strength. I am the strongest licensed CPA in the state of Florida. Maybe going for the Southeast Regional. I don't know, because your boy is getting jerked. Okay, you know it's what's up. What do you do, CPA Strength? I motivate, educate, and inspire, and I teach the world accounting the world over by basic blocks, basic blocks, basic blocks. Mainly by my mapping system, DCA, their debits, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue. I'm fired up today. It's going to be a good one. I think every video I try to get better, and this is the best video I've ever made coming up right now. I think this is like my 150th video. Let's go. This happens to be the best playlist in the world over here. If you just hit this card and all your dreams will come true, I guarantee that. A personal promise. All your dreams will come true. Yeah. Yeah. What is this? This is my classic series, but this is a sub-classic series of the main classic series. This is number 76. This is service revenue. More importantly than being accounting for beginners, number 76. This is road to 100. And we started on 73, 74, 75, 76 in our own little business, Widgets Inc. And we're selling widgets. We're selling widgets, and that's what we're doing for our business. And we're running through road to 100. 73 through 100 is just our business. And if you would like to, if you like the series, please give it a like. It really helps. Really, really, really helps. My video's out. Now, if you have any ideas for videos, please leave in a comment down below. I mean, like, if you want us to not have any money. I don't know why you would want us to not have any money to have all these expenses. But if you want to make us have like a really high service month or something, so we're swimming in the money, so we can freaking do stuff. Anyways, let's get into this one. I'm pumped up. I've been listening to music all morning. I think I found my schedule. I don't know. Woo! 76 service revenue. So we get some service revenue. So what's going on here? Widget Incorporated makes $2,000 for widget repairs. All right, Widget Incorporated, that's us. Let's wear our Widget Incorporated hat. And we are all shareholders. I'm on the books as shareholders, but you guys are on there too. We're going to do a journal entry. And then, you know, if you've been watching the starting from 73, if you know, we're going to do journal entry. We're going to do chart of accounts. We're going to do general ledger. We're going to do income statement and balance sheet. Let's go. Let's do a journal entry for this. Is there cash? Yeah, we're actually getting cash in this, so we love this. This should be our favorite journal entry. So we should know this one inside and out, because this should be our journal. This is my favorite journal entry. Debit cash, a credit service revenue. That is my favorite journal entry. So I don't know, like, tell me your favorite journal entry if this is not your favorite journal entry. Is this fun or what? You know, people say accountants don't have any imagination. I had to imagine making a hundred video series, and I'm going to 1,000. So you gotta have imagination. I'm doing this business here. I'm having imagination. Anyways, what's up with the journal entry? Yeah, we're getting cash. So if we're getting cash, and we're gonna put it into our checking account. So, I mean, I guess in real life you would look. In your bank statement, or your bank would have $2,000 coming into it, so you would know that it's revenue. So sometimes you might not know, you know, is this revenue, is this an expense, or just try to think logically and do the best you can, and everything will be fine. And practice. Let me move on out of I gotta move on out of this board. What the fork? See, if I'm feeling good about everything, something always tries to deflect me out, but it ain't gonna happen. Lego, come on, please. So, yes, we're getting money, we're getting cash, and $2,000. We're getting $2,000. So that would so cash, checking account, whatever is an asset. And we're getting it, so it's coming into the business, so it's going up. So let's go over to our DCA Adler chart. Where's the assets going up? Assets going up, debit. So there's our debit. Checking account, $2,000, which is an asset. What's our credit? Well, why did we get the $2,000? Because we did widget repairs, we service widgets, and that's our main thing. We service them. We might sell them later, I don't know, but we just service them now. We don't have all the equipment and all the inventory and whatnot. We got money for doing stuff in an ordinary course of business. That's a revenue. A revenue account's going up, so that's going to be our credit. It's either debit or credit. So there's our credit. Widget service 2,000 revenue. So our journal entry is 4. Widget Incorporated makes $2,000 for widget repair. Our journal entry is debit $2,000 checking account, which happens to be an asset. Credit widget service $2,000, which happens to be a revenue. All right, we're back in. Now we go to our chart of accounts. What did we add in our journal entry? What do we have in our journal entry? We had a checking account. We already had that in our chart of accounts. And we also had revenue widget services, which we did not have in our chart of accounts. So we just added it in. We added in a widget service under our revenue. It was our first revenue. So here's our chart of accounts currently. We have a checking account. We have a truck, which is a fixed asset. We have liabilities. We have a loan from shareholder. That's our only liability. Our only revenue is widget service. Our only expense is rent. But as you can see, every time we do a journal entry and we do not have an account for that journal entry in our chart of accounts, we just simply add it. It's easy like that. We just add it. Inside every account in our chart of accounts is the activity that happened. So let's start with our widget service. With the activity, because there was only one transaction on 4/30/15. Oh, that was when we did our journal entry this time. 4/30/15 is our fourth one. It's April. So all that happened was it increased by $2,000 to widget service on 4/30/15, our general ledger for widget service. Now the fun one, I think, of course, is our checking account. And I've tried to, maybe it'll come more if someone hasn't seen it before or you're watching the series for the first time. I just wanted to be very, very evident that mostly, you know, keeping the books for a business or doing this, I guess this is keeping the books, keeping up on, you know, journal entries, chart of accounts, general ledger, balance sheet, income statement. If there's 100 journal entries or 100 transactions, 95 or up is good. 95 of them, 95% is gonna be from the checking account. So what happened in our, what's going on in our general ledger checking account? This time at 4/30/15, we added $2,000. It started at 1/1/15 with 10,000 minus 4,000 minus 4,000 plus 2,000. So it has 4,000. So our checking account has $4,000 now. So here, checking account $4,000 in our general ledger checking account. Widget service $2,000 in our widget service general ledger account. Now I'm gonna have super fun. If you thought the checking account was fun, all right, looks great. Jump cut back in, boy. Now if I was saying if you thought that was fun, this is a lot of fun. This is like super duper fun. Now this is the balance sheet and the income statement. I want to say again, the reason why, because when I started working somewhere, I had the income statement on top of the balance sheet, and my like mentor guy said, no, balance sheet goes on first, and I'm like, why? And he goes, just because it just is. But through the years, this is about 4 years ago or something, 3-4 years ago. So now I figured out the reason the balance sheet goes on top is because the income statement is revenue minus expenses equals net income. So the totality of the income statement and net income flows over to the balance sheet. So with looking at the balance sheet being on top of the financial statements, you can see what's going on with assets equal liabilities plus equity. So you can see all that, and you can see the totality of revenue expenses. So you can see the whole business in a snapshot in like two seconds with the balance sheet. Now, the income statement for now is 1/1/15, that's when we started our business, to 4/30/15. That's how it is now. So it's the period. Income statement is a period. Boom, boom. As you can see, it's January to April in 2015. The balance sheet is one point in time. It's just for right now, right today, or the time now. Because it would probably be sometime in May by the time we're doing these journal entries, because you're in accounting, you're kind of working behind, right? Damn! So the balance sheet's 4/30/15. What happened this time? This time we finally made some revenue. So we got 2,000 minus 4,000 equals negative 2,000 net income. See, I think it was, we didn't have this, so it was negative 4,000 net income. Was negative 4,000 over here. But now we made $2,000, so now we have only negative $2,000 of net income. So we made 2,000, we've decreased our loss by $2,000. So that slides over to here. Now what's up with our balance sheet on 4/30/15? A couple things changed over here. In our checking account, we went from having $2,000 and we made $2,000, so we have $4,000 in our checking account, and our truck is still in the books for $4,000, so we have a total of $8,000 in our assets. Now, is that going to equal our liabilities plus equity? The liabilities didn't change. The equity did change because it was negative $4,000, but now it's negative $2,000. So our equity is negative $2,000, our liability is $10,000, that's $8,000 for liabilities and equity. Does that match the assets? Yes, it does. Well, that was the... Well. That was, I can always look up there, that was number 76, so can you believe we're almost on 76? I'm going to try to do this more often to where go faster and not talk so much about anything else but the actual problem at hand. And then if I have, because my camera only goes to 16 minutes and then it shuts off. So I'm going to run it out to 16. I'm going to try to go as fast as I can so I can talk at the end of the video. And so you don't have to like skip through the video, because I talked my shit in the beginning, you have to skip through that, find out where I start. I don't know, I'm talking a lot right now. It's just stuff that goes through my head. I finally found a good time to film and just do my life now, really until next tax season. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to be professional about it. I'm going to keep all the negative thoughts out of my head, because I have so many negative thoughts going running through my head. It's really a full-time job. Like, I don't know how many hours. I guess you're awake 16 hours a day. I'm trying to fight off the negative voices in my head. Like, 14 of the 16 hours that I'm awake. It's really hard for me. And, I am really trying to do it, and I guess doing stuff that I like doing helps me stay in a positive mood. So I like getting here in the morning at 3 o'clock and doing these accounting for beginners. I love it, actually. Anyways, I'm about out of time. Look, stay positive. Don't hate people. Be nice. Uplift people. Why are you going to remember to be a piece of shit fucking scumbag hater? Right? Like, be remembered uplifting people. Deuces. Ain't nothing shaking about my goddamn car keys.